Hi everyone, my name is Nancy. I am the exercise physiologist in the Zakim Center at Dana-Farber. Welcome today to our outside virtual studio. We are in the gorgeous Lars Anderson Park. It's the first day of fall here for us, so enjoy the sights and sounds here. We're gonna get ourselves warmed up here, so we're gonna be marching in place. And over the course of our warm-up, gonna start to take some deeper breaths together. So maybe in the beginning, you're just breathing through your nose and your mouth's closed. But probably as the warm-up goes on, those breaths will get a little deeper and you may find that opening your mouth up makes it a little bit more tolerable for you. So whatever you need. But we'll just take these few minutes. It's a warm day here in Boston, but knowing that for some of you, the house might be chilly, you might be chilly. So taking these minutes to get ourselves moving and grooving together. So the march is big or little, as much arm movement as you feel like you might need. We'll do three more, two more, one more. Now we do a V step. So we step forward a bit wide and then come back narrow. So this could be a really big V. You could cover a lot of ground as you're doing it. You could keep it a little bit smaller. Totally up to you. It's early in the warm-up, so kind of pace yourself accordingly. And our opportunity here, checking in with our feet, depending on footwear, flooring, just getting a sense of that foot hitting the floor. Three more, two more, one more. Now we're gonna march wide. So we're a little bit wider than we were with our initial march. Knees are still fairly forward facing. Again, arms can really start to crank up or be a little more leisurely on the sides. We're gonna go into alternating hamstring curls. So bending one knee and then the other. So our opportunity to get a little stretch in the front of our thighs. So gauging, you know, depends on what you've done so far today, what your last couple days have looked like, how these muscles might be feeling. Checking in with our knee joints themselves, this sort of bending and extending, serving as a little bit of pump, help move some fluid out and around. If you've been fairly sedentary this morning, a nice opportunity to get things moving again. Feeling those hamstrings in the back getting warmed up for what's ahead today. We'll do three more each side. Two more. One more. Now it's a side step. So like the V step, you can cover a lot of ground. You could add a hop if you really felt like it, or you could keep it on the smaller side. And then it's the same thing. It's an opportunity here. Do you want to get the arms up overhead, get a much bigger movement, get that heart rate up, get that body temperature up? Go for it. If it feels better at shoulder height, then we do that or we leave them out. So all throughout class, it's about kind of customizing for what you need today in your workout. We'll do three more each way. Two more. One more. So now we're going to do a knee and an elbow twist. So opposite elbow, opposite knee, and our theme continues. As big or as little as you need it. For some people, staying below hip height feels a bit better. If you have the flexibility and you want to come up higher, you certainly can, but not then getting any kind of back pain with it. That's not our goal here. So if your back is bothersome, then you just bring it a little lower, a little smaller, but a nice opportunity to get a little bit of rotation through our spine, wake things up a little bit. If you just ate, it's a chance to kind of help a little bit with digestion, move some of that food through. We'll do three more each side, two more, and one more. Okay. So we'll bring our feet still now and work a bit on mobility. of our hips and low back. So the first one is our shift and hinge. So we're gonna shift some weight into one leg, or a little bit more into one leg, and then hinge away from it. I like to keep one hand down, and then if it feels good to bring an arm overhead, then you'll do that. You could be at shoulder height, you could be all the way overhead, whatever feels good. Back to center, we'll do that two more times to this side. We inhale and shift, exhale and hinge. Reaching over, so really opening up this whole side body. Back to center, last one. Inhale, shift, exhale, hinge, and reach. Lots of nice space for those lungs, deeper breaths, back to center. Now we have the opposite side as comparison. We'll shift first, and then hinge and reach. And usually the sides feel pretty different. Very normal, we are not symmetrical beings here. So two more to this side, inhale, shift, and hinge, and reach. And again, the arm doesn't need to be where it was on the other side. Back to center, one more shift. Hinge and reach and back to center. And now we'll do some progressive shoulder rolls here. So we'll start fairly small, feet are hip distance apart, palms against the body. So we're gonna roll the shoulders forward, come way up to the ears, back behind us, and then down. Two more of these. Inhale forward and up. Exhale back and down. Nice big full circles. Last one. Inhale forward and up. And exhale back and down. So now, a little bit harder, we get the hands on the shoulders. Inhale forward and up. Those elbows travel forward. And then up, out, back, and down. Two more. Inhale forward and up. Exhale back and down. One more. If the overhead piece doesn't feel good, you could come up to shoulder height and then go back and down. And now we're gonna do the full arm. So starting by our sides, palms face each other. They're gonna travel up and overhead. When you get to your highest point, flip the palms to the side and then you're still traveling back and then down behind you. We'll do that twice more. Inhale forward and up. Reaching up towards the sky, flip those palms at your highest point, back and down. One more, knowing you can just come up here to shoulder height, flip those palms, travel through and down. Okay, hopefully you feel nice and warmed up and open and ready to go. So we'll grab a sip of water. I will do my best to cue you during class today to be staying hydrated, but knowing if I'm not cueing it, you are always welcome. Definitely want to keep our body hydrated today, so keeping that water bottle nearby. So some things that we're gonna need today, you see my yoga mat here. If you don't have a yoga mat, you know, towels, blankets, are great. If you're on carpet, you may not even need it. If you're going to do this in your bed, not going to need it either. I'm using a blanket here for some height when I'm on the ground. Again, pillows, blankets, towels are a great option. I've got a chair here for balance. I've got some light dumbbells. And so depending on what you've got at home, if you have a variety of weights nearby, bringing those over. If you don't have any weights at home, it is totally fine. You can use soup cans and water bottles, maybe don't even need to use weights at all. So knowing that, I also have a yoga block that we're gonna use at one point. If you don't have a yoga block, it's fine. Maybe you could grab a tissue box that can often, although not too big of a tissue box, and you'll see why in a little bit. So that piece is more on the optional side. So knowing if you don't have those things, it is totally fine. So the way the class will go, we're gonna do three circuits together today. Two of them are gonna be standing. One of them is gonna be down, again, on our mat or on the in your bed. I am going to demonstrate every single set for a minute. The goal for you today is to join me for as much of the minute as you feel like you comfortably can. So it is not, particularly this is your first class, it is not your goal to do everything with me for the full minute on every single exercise. As you do this video more often, hopefully you'll be able to see yourself. First day 15 seconds, the next day 20 seconds, and building up from there. Okay, so our first exercise is going to be a squat. So I'm gonna demonstrate this without weights. If you feel like you want to hold onto some weights, you may go ahead and do that. So for squats, you're gonna be about hip distance apart, trying to keep your upper body up fairly tall here. Arms where they're comfortable. They could be by your side holding weights or not holding weights, or here in, you know, in front of you, whatever feels best. Our timer's gonna start. We're gonna squat down and then we're gonna come on back up. So squats have a lot of individual variation to them depending on our bodies, injuries, surgeries, just sort of generally how the body is feeling today. Some people prefer to squat to a chair. Some people prefer, if you're at home, you can go up to a wall. Doing a wall squat will help keep that posture up a little taller, will help a bit with balance if that's a challenge for you. So some options, always a good thing. We want to make sure that we're coming down as far as feels comfortable. This is about it for me and my range of motion in my knees and my hips. Some of you can likely sink a lot lower. So go for that. Don't feel like you necessarily have to be mirroring me on every single repetition. We're going to do one more together. Down and up. So hopefully you felt the fronts of the thighs, so we get our quads and potentially our hamstrings and our glutes. We had a lot of bang for our buck with that exercise. Next, we are going to do a row. So a chair is a nice option. You don't have to use a chair. You could just hinge forward, so it's up to you. We're going to do a rowing motion. We are going to be targeting some of our larger postural muscles, so this is an opportunity to potentially grab a slightly heavier weight, or again, having something heavier and something lighter nearby. I like to come into a sort of split squat variation with one foot forward and one foot back. So the leg that's forward, that hand comes on the chair. I'm going to hinge forward from my hips. You'll notice my long spine, so I'm not rounded. The palm is facing my body. I'm going to go ahead and pull up and in and then slowly back down. So again, great for posture. And it's sort of similar to that motion of like starting a lawnmower where you want to think about be pulling and driving that energy up and back with the arm. We want the fist to wind up right about that hip bone at the top. Sometimes we tend to kind of stop here with this weight pretty far forward. We want to try to get all the way up and in if we can. We've got that little bit of a chin tuck, so we're not staring at our feet. We're gazing in front of us. Trying to crack that walnut between the shoulder blades at the top here. And when we come slowly back down, we are done on that side. So I'm going to go ahead and switch the chair. And then I've got to switch my feet and switch my hands. So again, that leg that's forward, that hand comes on the chair. Arm is forward. We go ahead and pull up and back down. So gauging, how did that first set feel for you? Did you grab a fairly heavy weight and it was challenging? The home environment is sometimes tough because we don't always have all the weights that we might have normally had in a gym environment. So if you don't quite have something heavy enough, you're going to go slower than I'm going. And you're going to add a little pause here at the top. Really thinking about squeezing those upper body muscles, upper back. And then trying to lower that arm back down as slowly as you can. It's easy to let gravity kind of drop it We don't want to let that happen. We want to control that lowering phase of the weight. We're going to do one more of these together, so we'll come all the way down. Exhale up, twist that elbow in just slightly towards center spine, and down. Okay. So that was round one of circuit one. So now we're going to repeat each of those one more time. So you had some exposure to the squats. Did you need weight? Do you not need weight? Do you want to use the wall? Whatever you need. So again, feet are hip distance apart, give or take. You might need to be a little wider, a little closer. Upper body up tall, arms where they're comfortable. We're going to squat down and then come on up. So if we do a little body scan when we're doing these, starting with our feet, you want your weight to be fairly equal. So I don't want you squatting down and then your heels lift. I also don't want you squatting down and being so far back that your toes lift. So finding that middle ground, you're going as low as feels comfortable. That's going to be different for all of us. You want those knees to still stay about hip distance apart. What will happen in some bodies is the knees will cave in. What will happen in other bodies is the knees will point out. So if that is happening, making sure that things stay nice and aligned. Sometimes it's helpful if you can be in front of a mirror to practice some of these and see if that is happening in your body. We're gonna do one more of these together, down. And exhale up. So hopefully felt those, again, could have been in the front of the thighs, the backs of the thighs, or the glutes. We'll go back to our rows. We're gonna grab a quick sip of water. So Nancy does a good job at keeping us all hydrated today. So with our rows, we are going to go ahead and start on the side we finished on. So we're ready to go here. So foot that's forward, that arm comes onto the chair. Opposite hand comes forward, palms facing in towards the body. We exhale up, slight twist in and back down. So I do keep turning my head to look at the camera, but for all of you, you're gonna keep that head nice and neutral. That's gonna help keep the neck in alignment and keep that neck from getting upset with you from doing these, getting a little achy. On a nice neutral, almost a little bit of a chin tuck, so you're not gazing at your feet, you're just looking forward on the floor. Those nice deep breaths, so we exhale up, again that little twist in at the top, and down. Again, if these are easy, you're gonna go a little slower, so we'll go nice and slow on this last one, up. Pause, slight tuck in, and down. Okay, excellent work. We'll switch our chair, switch our feet and our weight. Again, I'm leaning into this front knee, hand on the chair, shoulders facing the chair, hinge forward. Exhale up, inhale down. So sometimes we think we get stronger on this part of the move, on the lift, because honestly, it is sort of the harder part of it to pull the weight up than it is to lower. But in fact, actually get a lot of our really good strength gains by controlling on the way down. So making sure that you aren't just dropping it, but you are controlling it. So it's sort of equal counts up and equal counts down. So it may be helpful in your head. 1,000, 2,000, 3. 1,000, 2,000, 3. We'll do one more up. Slight tuck in and down. So really anywhere in this upper back, you know, down the side, I mean, technically your lat muscles come way down by your waist. So any of those, are good for where you might be feeling it. We'll grab a quick sip before circuit two. So anytime I teach, our circuit two starts with some balance. I think we all need to be doing some good balance work together. So we're gonna do a calf raise today. So we're gonna start with our feet hip distance apart. We're right in front of our chair. Again, you could use a wall for this one as well. That is totally fine. And we want to imagine here that we've got nice tall spine, so everything is sort of stacked and aligned, and then there's a string from the top of our head. So we've got fingertips for balance. We're going to come up onto the tippy toes, as high up as you can get, and then slowly back down. So again, trying to avoid what often happens is we go forward and then back down. We want to think about that energy pulling us straight up and back down. And as I mentioned, this is our balance portion. So can you go down to a couple of fingertips? Can you play with letting go? Balance is a sneaky thing. Some days things feel really good. Other days it's really hard to feel very stable. So using the chair as much as you need it so that you can get that full, all the way up onto the tippy toes, all the way back down. If you're not feeling these, then you're gonna go ahead and linger a little bit longer at the top and back down. We'll do one more together. Straight up again, make sure you're not leaning forward, and down. Okay, so hopefully you felt that somewhere in that calf muscle. Might have been high up below the knee, might have been down by the ankle. It's totally fine. So we're gonna go ahead upper body wise and do some bicep curls. So for these, you know, medium-ish weight is probably pretty good. Most of us use our biceps on a fairly, you know, on a daily basis, anytime we're picking up laundry baskets and grocery bags and things like that. So our biceps are fairly strong. So we are hip distance apart, and we're gonna do what's often referred to as a hammer curl. So we're actually starting with our palms facing one another. So what we're gonna do here as our timer starts is we curl up, and now you'll notice my palms are facing my body. And then as I come down, they're facing each other. So this movement and this little bit of twist that I'm doing is getting a bit of forearms. So having stronger forearms can be very helpful in our day-to-day lives, particularly if we're struggling to open up jars. These muscles are very important in that sort of grip strength and ability to open jars. So very functional move in that way. You'll notice as you see me from the side that my elbows are kind of slightly tucking into my body. So I'm not letting them travel forward. They're also not back here somewhere. So nice and locked in tight. Do one more of these. Exhale up, squeeze at the top. And inhale back down. Excellent work. We will put our weights down. We'll grab another little sip of water before we go back to our calves. So I will up the ante on this second set. If the first set felt on the easier side, then we're going to go ahead and do it one-legged. So if you're up for that challenge, you can join me for that. So we're gonna start on one leg, knowing you can stick with the two-legged version. So here's our one-legged one. We come up onto those tippy toes and back down. Now, of course, we're only gonna do this for 30 seconds because we need to do each leg in this minute. And these are generally pretty hard. So you're generally more than ready at the 30-second mark to go ahead and switch to the other side. But it is a nice opportunity. We're generally a little bit imbalanced, so often one leg is a little bit stronger. So this is our last one with this leg. And down. So you may find that now when we switch to this other leg, that in fact, one leg is stronger than the other. So here we go, up and down. And we've got that same energy as before where it's straight up. So we want to avoid, again, that leaning forward. So these are hard. So you knowing at any point you can drop back to doing two, but this is a nice way, if you do this video for a while, to get stronger. Last one up and down. Excellent work. All right, we will go ahead and go back to our bicep curls again. So doing a little assessment, how did that first set feel? If you have something heavier and you want it, go ahead and grab it. If you don't have anything heavier, you're just gonna go slower than me on set two here. So we're standing up tall, slight squeeze of those elbows, palms face one another. Exhale up, palms are facing the shoulders at the top, and down. So one other thing we wanna be mindful of with these bicep curls is sometimes when we get to the top of the movement, we get this little like extra wrist movement. I sometimes call them floppy wrists or bunny wrists, where we're not quite engaged fully at the top. And unfortunately, that can not be great on the wrist joint in some bodies. So one of the things that I find to be helpful for myself is really holding on tight. And even if you're not holding a weight, that you're making a fist. So you've got that good, solid energy, all those muscles in the arms working together here so that you're not, again, getting a little floppy at the top, even if it means a smaller range. Last one, up, squeeze those biceps at the top and down. All right, excellent work. So we are done with the standing portion of class. So we're gonna go ahead and utilize our yoga mats. Again, your bed is wonderful if the floor is feeling a little far away today. We are going to be laying on our back for the first set of circuit one. And actually the second set, I may show you a seated, more advanced version. And we may, again, need either a yoga block at this point, if you've got it. If you have like a longer rectangular Kleenex box, people have used like board game boxes. I've had people get very creative. Major bonus points to my Zakim regulars for using what we have in the house. So we're gonna go ahead and lay down on our back here. So I find that having just a little bit of height is helpful for me when I'm laying down. I know for a lot of people, laying completely flat is uncomfortable. I just wouldn't want you necessarily like laying on a yoga block or anything too high. So just taking advantage at home, grabbing a blanket or a towel and knowing you don't need it. If you're comfortable laying flat, then go for it. So I'm gonna lay back. So we're gonna work the front of our thighs. We're gonna work our quads here. So this variation today, we're gonna straighten one leg on the floor and the other leg is gonna be bent. And I definitely wanna encourage that this leg stays bent. Sometimes people wind up having both straight. This bent leg is gonna help keep our pelvis nice and stable, which will be important in this exercise. So before we even start, what we want to think about doing is pulling the toes up towards our head, straightening and engaging the quad even before you start. So really straightening through that knee joint. From here, I'm gonna lift my leg up nice and slow. You'll notice I'm still going up, still going up. I get to about the height of the opposite knee and then I go down and you'll notice like I'm moving through mud all the way down. When I get to the bottom, I'll release, I'll re-engage that quad muscle, pull those toes up and lift again. So this is an exercise that often can get a bit of momentum, and people can wind up kind of swinging this leg and then doing a lot of movement through their pelvis. So I'm really going to encourage slow, and that you keep that knee really straight and that foot really flexed. So there really shouldn't be any movement in your pelvis. So particularly when you get towards the bottom part of the movement, that you don't arch that back or flare those ribs, kind of keeping everything connected in the center of your body. And back down, we'll do one more of these. Really flex that foot at the bottom, slowly lifting up. Again, just the height of the other knee, higher isn't necessarily better. Slowly down. Okay, so now we'll switch. So again, we want to make sure that that opposite knee is bent, and then that opposite leg will straighten on the floor, flex that foot, lifting up. Again, not too high, just that height of that opposite leg, and down. Again, you can take that little break at the bottom, point the foot, reflex it, re-engage, and up. So hopefully, once we get kind of like halfway through, you want to really start to feel those muscles in the front of the thigh. It tends to start out on the easier side, but as we're nearing our last rep together, flex that foot, push through that heel actively, and back down. Nice work. Can bend both knees. Maybe do a little gentle windshield wiper. And now we're going to go to our core portion of the class. So this is where we need our block. Or again, whatever object you have in the house. And if you don't have anything, you're simply, when we do it, we're going to hold it between our hands up here. So if you don't have it, you're just imagining. So we can always be creative in the home environment here. So I grab on either end of the block. I'm going to push it up to the ceiling, to the sky here. I'm going to bring one leg up into what I think of as tabletop. So we want a 90 degree bend at the hip, 90 degrees at the knee, and 90 degree at that ankle joint. From here, what we're going to do is lower this leg down in the direction of the ground, the floor, and then back up. Your heel does not actually need to touch the ground. That is not necessarily the goal. When I think about sort of direction versus destination, we're moving in the direction of the ground, but that's not necessarily where we have to wind up, particularly if it means getting to the floor means you arch through your low back. That is not going to be a good thing for the lower back. So really trying to tune in and be aware of what is going on in your lower back. It should be pretty flush the entire time. Maybe a little bit of sort of your normal arch there, but not much more than that. So nice and slow for our last one. Traveling down, I'm still flexing my foot. And up. Okay. So you can put the block off to the side. Again, big fan of the windshield wipers. Just maybe it feels good at this point to straighten the legs out a little bit, shake them out a little bit, whatever you feel like you need. Because of course we have to do the other side together. So we start again, both knees bent, push those arms up to the ceiling, actively squeeze into the block or whatever object you're holding. We come into tabletop with that opposite leg, and we're going down and up. So we talked a bit about positioning in the last one. Now we want to think about the breath piece of this. So the inhale versus the exhale. And for some people, I find there's some individual variation. So you can kind of play with this a little bit on this set and see. Do you like to exhale down? Like birthday candle exhale, big exaggerated exhale and an inhale up. Or do you prefer it the other way, where you exhale as you lift up and you inhale down? Honestly, the most important thing to me is that you are breathing. So choosing which one, if one just feels a little bit more natural for you, then that's the one that I'm going to want you to try to do. If one of them feels very forced and very awkward and it's tripping you up, then go ahead back to the other variation. All about what works for our own individual bodies. Last one. And up. Whew. Okay. Put that block off to the side. And now we're going to go back to those quad lifts. And I forgot, I'm actually going to come up to seated. So knowing you can repeat that version, or you're going to roll to your side. So this is sort of the advanced version. This is where you may or may not want your yoga block. The one thing I will say is you don't want to pick anything too heavy. Trust me. So we are going to start seated. You're going to bring your hands forward. Sometimes when we get in this position, people want to be back here and kind of lounging at the beach. We're up nice and tall today. So that object is just outside my opposite leg. Again, hands in front. My timer's going to start. I'm going to lift my leg up. I travel over my block and down. So now you can see why I didn't want you to pick anything too high. So go ahead. And again, you don't need anything. You just can imagine something there. It's totally fine. Or particularly if what you've chosen now all of a sudden feels really high, go ahead and move it. As long as you're lifting the leg and bringing it out and down, you're fine. So these probably feel fairly or significantly harder than the position on your back. And it tends to get really isolated kind of right here in the center of our quad. They start out on the easier side, and then all of a sudden it's kind of this very pinpointed. So do as many as you can once we come up and in, we're done. Woo. So it just goes to show, sometimes we think the really heavy exercises are the hard ones. And honestly, when we're just moving the weight of a limb, it's a lot harder than we think. So now we have to do the other side. So we shift the block over. Again, hands forward, nice tall spine. Up, out, down. Up, in, down. So making sure you're also not leaning back, because now, of course, if I had a much taller object, I could get over it. But that's not the goal. Again, I'd rather have you stay up tall and kind of barely like lift your leg up, almost like drag it across the floor or the grass, or you're still getting plenty of work. The height actually really isn't the goal of this particular exercise. So playing around with what version feels good, but not leaning back. So trying to keep tall spine. This one in some bodies is more bothersome in their hip flexors and their hips. So that position on our back that we didn't set one is great. So we never want to push through, particularly joint pain that's very stabby, sort of sharp shooting pain. Last one out and in. So if that is the case, we always want to modify. This is also a sneaky one where you may not feel it later today, but you might feel it tomorrow or even the day after that. So sometimes I forget because it's been 2 days and then I remember what we had done together. So not sure why I got rid of my block, because I need it for my second set of core. So we go ahead. If you need some height, just adjust it. Get yourself nice and lined up, nice neutral neck and spine. Gonna bring those arms up. We're gonna start on the side we finished on. So again, 90 hip, 90 knee, 90 ankle. So you play with the breathing. If you prefer to exhale, down, inhale up, or inhale down, and exhale up. But very common when we do a lot of core work to hold our breath. Not really good particularly for any of my abdominal surgery folks out there. We always want to be managing that pressure in our core. So breathing nice, big, full, deep breaths. And that's where I encourage that like birthday candle exhale. That's almost a, you know, pursed lips, forcing that air out will help again with that sort of pressure management. Shaking at this point is normal. We've got one more with this leg. Whew. So certainly these two moves combined together, we got a lot of quad work, that those legs may be kind of shaking and quaking a little bit at this point, and that is normal. So now we've got to do this other side one more time. Arms up, they're really active too. So not bent here, it's as if you're holding, you know, a big tray of drinks up here. And again, we check in 90 degrees, 90 degrees, 90 degrees. Inhale down or exhale, really what works for you, and up. So there's a fair amount to think about in this particular exercise. So for me, I'm kind of constantly doing a bit of a body scan, because I find as I focus on my foot or what my leg's doing, maybe I start to arch my spine. Maybe my elbows start to take a little breather. So when you're kind of constantly scanning, that way whatever part of the movement might have started to try to take it easy, we make sure that everything is kind of dialed in and working together. So we're pushing into the block or the object that you might be holding. And we'll do one more of these together, slowly down, not arching that back, and up. Woof. So that block or object can go off to the side. We'll bring both knees into the chest. I just sort of naturally wind up rocking a little bit side to side. A little massage for that low back. And then we're gonna go ahead and be mindful of what's around us, because we're gonna roll to one side, so you don't wanna land on anything, and then your top hand will prop you up into seated. And my opportunity to thank you all for joining me today to get yourself a little stronger. I greatly appreciate it. So again, I'm Nancy. I'm the exercise physiologist at Dana-Farber in the Zakim Center. And knowing if there were exercises that were challenging for you, things you have questions about, modifications you might need, I am available for free exercise consultations. It's a wonderful opportunity to get questions, help you set some goals, help with modifications. So I'm going to give you our website where you can get information about that consult, but you can also see all of our different videos. So if this was your first one, there's lots more strength training. There's yoga classes, Tai Chi, Qigong. We've got nutrition. We've got mindfulness. We've really run the gamut there. So I encourage you to check that out. Our website is myzakim.dana-farber.org. So come and check us out, and we hope to see you again soon. Thank you.